Crown Buick GMC, where we run on relationships. And Tim's Marine Incorporated, your authorized local Yamaha dealer, present Cajun Quest, the Louisiana fishing show. Hello, anglers, and welcome to another Cajun Quest. Let's head down to the Big Easy for some great trout action with the master of Pontchartrain trout, Captain Dudley Vandenborre, inventor of the Deadly Dudley. Along with us on this trip is Craig Lanier from North Carolina. He'll give us some tips on fishing with one arm. Despite a hard southwest wind, the fishing was great. I'm your host, Mike Rabelais, and you're watching Cajun Quest.
I thought he was fighting off a lot like a red. He was pounding that head, doesn't he?
Yeah.
So we got on the fish. And all we had to do was move a little way from where we were. Keep still. Keep still. Well, I got my line pulled. Boy, he had it too. He wasn't letting go. Good. Go back and have another try at it. Well, he piqued my interest. Ready to catch some more. He didn't really thump it hard. So redfish, that's unusual. When I felt that head thumping, I said, that's why I said it feels like a red. He was way off the red. Yeah. All it takes sometimes is a little change of location. It's like real estate. The important thing is location, location, location. Well, I hope we do it again today. Folks, I'd like y'all to meet Craig Lanier. Craig is from North Carolina, and Craig is your bait rep.
I am the fishing tackle buyer for New Smoke Shop in Ketchikan.
Fishing tackle buyer. Now, Craig, as you notice, Craig has one arm, and Craig is fishing a spinning rod. Craig, tell us a little bit about how you do this. I had a viewer email me one time that had one arm also and asked if we had any information on rigs that were made for amputees or whatever, you know, just to help them out a little bit. But you rigged your own rig up, didn't you?
Yes, sir. I have been, for the past 30 years, I have just done some experimenting with rods, and I find that just cutting the reel seat off the rod when I get it so it doesn't have a hump in it to hurt my nub, and find a rod that's got a long handle on it, and just taping my reel one with black tape.
It's in that you don't have that bump under there.
Right.
Well, this is called a Tennessee rig anyway. A lot of spin cast rods come with a rig that has no reel seat in it. It's just made to tape onto the, and it's called a Tennessee rig. And it works excellently for Craig. I've been watching him this morning, and I'm anxious to see you hang a fish and
me too.
Get you on camera.
Me
but,
too.
Just because you have an amputation doesn't mean you have to stop fishing. And Craig's living proof of that, and I've seen, like I was telling you earlier, I saw a young man fishing at Toledo Bend fishing with a topwater bait,
right,
with an amputated right arm, and he was using his knees to give the bait action. So if you want to do it bad enough, there's a way to do it.
Absolutely. You have to have the want to.
Yeah. Now, all it takes is a little bit of want to.
That's right.
As a matter of fact, they've got rigs out there for double amputees.
Really?
Yeah. They've got electric reel rigs, and I guess it's called the prosthesis that they have is made to fit a rod and reel, and the reel is electric, so they don't have to reel.
I know that there's a company that makes salt water.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Called Electromate.
Yeah. And they have made some you know, smaller rigs to fish not just salt water, but brackish water,
right,
too. So all it takes is a little desire to do it. There you go. A Trout. He's a baby. We'll take him right now.
We sure will.
He was way off that bridge.
Yeah, I saw that.
Way off that bridge.
Here we go, Craig.
Just a grunt.
Did he hit it hard, Craig?
Yeah, hit it real good. Yeah, hit it real good, Dudley. You gonna save him or throw him back? He got one.
No, I don't have one. I got something off the bottom. Another line. Them lines feel good.
It sure does, and these fish are scared as they are.
I'm telling you. Got a chop on the water today. There he is. Good fish, too. Huh? I feel like another redfish. Pumping that head. He won't come up. Still acting like a red. I hope it's a big trout.
I hope it's a big trout.
Good one. Me too. Pull and drag like that, I hope it's a trout. Coming up to the top. Never felt him hit. Just saw my line jump sideways. Come on, let us see you anyway. Don't be no catfish. Whatever it is, it's a good fish.
It's getting the kinks out of your mess, man.
Telling you.
Old gaff.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Oh, what?
There you go.
No, whatever it is, a good fish. Big trout.
Big trout.
Big trout.
Big trout.
Not, no. Not no wall hanger, but it's a puller. I'll take it every day.
Beautiful trout.
That's a good one, Dudley.
That's what we come after.
Look at the belly on that girl. Well, my first trout of the day. That's a good one. About five and a half, I'd say. Beautiful fish. Go back and do it again for me sometime. Thank you. I enjoyed that ride. That fish is thumping his head just like a redfish, doesn't
it? It came up one time. I saw it.
I saw a flash, but I couldn't. All I saw was the end part, you know. I'll take that any day.
I was hoping it was a big one trip
there. It was a good one. Deadly Dudley. Terra tail and avocado collar, little Captain Brent Roy's line yop juice on it, and hang on. Dudley got another one here. Big one, my friend. Yeah, pretty good. Another real pretty good. Boy, that's some pulling trout, isn't it?
Oh, they're getting this tired.
Pulling like it weighs 7 pounds.
Yeah.
Pulling like it's a good one.
Else,
you don't want him, do you, mate?
Fishing on Lake Pontchartrain gets better every year. Like we were talking a little earlier. How many over 7 pounds did you say you caught in the last week or so, Dudley? 20?
We had about 20 fish, yeah. Over 7.
20 fish. Ooh, look at that. 20 fish over 7 pounds, and one of them over 10. Matter of fact, 10 and a half pounds to be exact.
Two nines up in that.
Two nines.
Three or
four. That one right there that I just caught was probably in the 5.5 pound range. It was a good one. And they are pulling good too. And I just missed another fish. That was a pulling trout. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. That's an even bigger fish.
Took off like a good one.
Yes, he did. I got it, Craig.
He won't come up either.
He ain't wanting to see you, Dudley.
He's not that big, a redfish.
Oh, is that what it is? Yep. 2 pound redfish will pull like a 10 pound trout. Pretty fish though. If you're gonna keep a redfish, that's the size to keep. You can do anything you want to with them guys. That trout. Look at that.
Got it?
Oh, got off. I started reeling it, he nailed it.
Following it,
huh? Yep.
Oh, I got him still, I think. Didn't catch up with him.
That's what happened to me with that one. I couldn't catch up with him.
He's not too big.
My other trout could eat that one. Remember that day you stuck that trout in there?
Yeah.
Other trout's mouth? Look where I was casting.
Yeah, this is one corner where we've caught them. No man's land.
They probably scatter out on this flat out there. There's a lot of shell out there. And they'll scatter out and follow the bait around. That's something you jig that bait off of the bottom like that for a long time. You have nothing, and you start to reel it in. Wow! I wasn't ready for him. Felt like a decent fish too. I bowled that Kissel rod up.
Got the line.
Right.
Well.
I know I missed that last one. I loosened my drag up for that big trout. Oh, a little bitty flounder. Little bitty spotted flounder. You got my interest, though. Come on back, little guy. See you when you get to be about 7-8 pounds. Put you on the grill then. That little bitty thing was fighting hard.
I think they opened
it probably. Yeah. Finicky fish, aren't they? There you go. Looks like you're getting in closer to the bridge all of a sudden. Oh, pretty trout. I wish we cut that on camera. That'd have been.
I don't know if you can come over this right.
Perfect shot. Got another one over here, Frank. Jumping like a bass. We did a little dance there, didn't we?
Tried to. Thank you, Mike.
You're welcome, sir.
Quick release.
Quick release. Two good trout, back to back. And that was, what, about a four you had, Dudley? There you go. Ooh, good fish. Good fish. I don't know. That big speck did like that a while ago. Pounding his head pretty good, eh?
Yeah, you know what that is. Unless I got him hooked sideways.
Trout? No, no, that's a trout. Come here. Almost gives me a Tego Hagen on that one, doesn't it? Almost performed a Dego Hagen on you. And if that had been an 8-pound trout, I'd have had to do it.
Yeah. Beautiful trout.
There you go. And Dudley turns around and catches it.
There you go.
Alrighty.
They always good when they do that.
Yep.
No, he's not that big. I thought he was big
enough. Ain't no baby. You flipping?
Yeah, I get him.
Routine down with these
Cajun Quest.
They know they all have
Dudley,
just didn't give up.
I wish they were that easy.
Yeah.
I know a couple of them I wish would have just gave up.
If that were the case, I'd buy me a Dudley Max.
There you go.
Yeah, Craig, fishing with Dudley is a humbling experience. Might be a striper.
I doubt it. But that'll
be a striper here.
Yeah. Craig was telling us about the striper fishing they do in North Carolina with a Deadly Dudley. That's why I said that might be a striper. He might have followed you from North Carolina.
Yeah.
If that's a trout, that's a hog, man.
That's a trout. That's what I come to Louisiana for.
Yeah. Get him up in that motor.
It's a trout and it's a hog.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, yeah. Nice fresh.
There you go.
That's what I come for.
That's a beauty. Thank you, Dudley.
Nice. What you caught him? What color?
That same color I just put on. I'm glad I decided to put that color on. Beautiful fish. Beautiful fish. Uh-huh, he come back.
Hey,
he decided he didn't want mine.
What we did then? Good fish, that's right?
Yeah,
nice fish. Nice fish.
Another good fish, Craig. This one might be a little bigger than the last one. No, he's about the same size. There you go, sir. Matter of fact, I think the last one was bigger.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, the last one a lot bigger.
Yeah. Pontchartrain trout.
Pontchartrain mule trout. Just had it hit in the same spot and he went to pick up Craig.
See that?
Wasn't it?
Oh. I don't know what he did in
That guy, if he'd had that film on him, he come cutting you through. I think he went over your line and everything, didn't he?
I think he did. I think he jumped clean over it. Dudley, where's he going?
I don't know. Excuse me. Okay.
See, that's where I want that big one hooked. I got him hooked in that hard part of his mouth where.
It was a terrific day for fishing, despite the southwest wind and the dingy water. The combination of Captain Dudley's Terra-Tail Deadly Dudley and Captain Brent Roy's Lagniappe Juice proved too much for the trout. Again, I picked up some information on how to fish for those Pontchartrain mules from Captain Dudley. If you'd like a shot at a wall mount-sized trout, give Captain Dudley a call at the number on your screen. Thanks also to Craig Lanier for his information on his fishing technique. He was a blast to fish with. For more information on fishing Pontchartrain, log on to Mike Lane's website at www.rodandreel.com. There's all kinds of good information for the hunter and angler on the site. For some great recipes and maps of where we fish, log on to our website at www.cajunquest.net. Well, that's it for this week's show. Till next week, please remember to use your life jacket and your kill switch, and please don't throw your trash on our roads and waters. This has been Mike Rabelais for Cajun Quest. Stay safe on the water and good fishing. We'll see you next week.